Hey guys, so ever since I made this channel, I have always wanted to make my own characters in 3D. At first, I knew that I had to practice a bit more. As you can see, here is an early attempt on one of my original characters named Pamm. So for this video, I remade her in Blockbench with her new overall design. I would also give some interesting character info about her and some lore in my original universe. So, without further ado, let's get into the process of making. As often as I do, I start with the blocking. You can see in the reference background some drawings I have made before of my character. In my original design and aim for Pamm, she is supposed to be thin, sometimes frail, but usually strong. I didn't want to make her the prettiest character out there. So I tried to make her face have sort of a balance between looking alright and looking average. In her world, she is a scavenger. She usually looks for junk that she could either sell or make something out of. I wanted her to be thin since she is a character that keeps on hopping from places to places, hoping to find scraps. She really doesn't get to eat on the right time, and even if she does manage to grab some grub, it's usually not the most nutritious ones. Also, she is thin because she lives in an artificial planet with an artificial gravity. So, yeah. You can see in the video that even in low poly, I try not to over-exaggerate her body features. Not that I have something against it, but I just don't really like that type of approach. She is meant to be an average character with no real goal in life. Well, none until she meets one of my other original characters, which I will tell you guys about if I ever make another one of these. Character lore aside, an advice that I can give you guys when it comes to low poly is sometimes you can go and add a bit more polygons while making your model. You can see here that her shirt or polo is a bit more complex, since I wanted it to have visible wrinkles. I later fixed it by deleting some of the faces and vertices, which made it look a lot better. You have to remember that you are still going to texture this model, and that textures would have to do all the heavy lifting when it comes to visual elements. For the legs, it was pretty simple. I just used an elongated pentagon and separated it in half. I do recommend that you make your arms and legs in one mesh, and then just split it later. It makes the process of sticking the limbs together a lot easier, and it looks a lot better. By this time, I have become more confident when making the faces of my models, so much that I started to embed all the facial features into one mesh. However, if you do try and replicate my method, when it comes to faces, try and make limited loop cuts first. Trust me, if you were to go and add 5 or more loop cuts, either front or sides, you would have a much harder time trying to get the face shape that you want. Another thing that I added when making faces was a slight indent on the lip area. I noticed that when viewing my old models from the side that it was looking a bit flat. I also learned this from a PS1 model. I did it first on a commission and really liked it, so now I just do it with all of my models. I am just going to let this process play a bit longer. The ears are a bit complex, but basically, I have 2 loop cuts on these sides and just extrude a couple of rectangular faces. It looks complicated, but not really. Practicing it would really help make your models look a lot better. Here is the polo or shirt fix that I was mentioning earlier. In my original design, and seen from the first Pamm model, she used to wear a yellow shirt. I really liked the yellow shirt, that even in my later designs, it was her inner shirt. I changed it to the blue since it seemed to look a lot better. But I don't know, which one do you prefer? For her hair, I first fixed the top of her head with better topology. Then I duplicated that mesh and made it as the base for the hair. 80% of the hair was easy to make. What made it really difficult and complex was the bangs and the hair strand that slices out. Since these were curved, I took a lot of trial and error to see how I would be able to approach this. What I figured was just to extrude simple edges. It gave me enough flexibility and mobility to be able to match the hairstyle from the reference. Her shoes is a big part of her character. My original vision for her was to be a badass character who has the ability to perform great and awesome kicks using her boosted boots. Basically, she can kick faster and hover above the ground since she has a small jet on her ankle that gives her this ability. I kept that idea but changed her to a scavenger. I thought that it would be a lot cooler if she didn't formally learn those kicks, and that the kicks that she knows were like from stuff she just thought of or just seen in movies. Though she is underweight, she can give you a very powerful kick. But she doesn't like for people to get hurt, though they hurt her. So for her to not feel that guilty, she puts padded materials on her shoes, which are the extruded parts you see on the video. These are soft pads that help lessen the impact on the person. Also, it helps cover her footsteps so that she could scavenge, but mostly steal from bad guys. Yep, she steals from bad guys. As promised last time, I would be uploading a separate UV mapping tutorial. But for now, here is how I do it. I first make a texture for the face using the 128 multiple, since that is the texture size that most PS1 models use. Then I turn on the UV overlay to be able to see the individual mappings on the texture file. Then I go to edit mode and select faces. Then I click on the faces I want to for the side view. Then I try to match the size of the UV map from the automated one. And that is about it. I use the number keypads on my keyboard to have an orthographic view of every direction. Here, you can see me sketching out the facial features. I did this to see whether or not the UV maps are big enough for me to draw enough details for the face. I found that it wasn't enough, and so I enlarged the UV mappings a little bit, which gave me enough pixels to work with. When I draw Pamm on paper, her eyes are just literally triangles. The triangles are meant for strong characters, but I use it for the opposite reason for Pamm. That's why in this texture, I try and give her eyes a bit more curves. Also, if you guys have a channel or video on pixel art that can help me, do comment it down below. I still really need to improve my pixel art skills. There was no need for me to create a complex hair texture, so I just shaded it and called it a day. I did the same UV mapping method on the body. It was a bit easier to UV map since the mesh didn't have faces that were extruded. From this point on, it was just the matter of mapping and texturing. So to not really annoy you guys with my voice, I will see you when the video is about to end. Enjoy the texturing time lapse. As you just saw, I still added some stuff from the actual design. The shin guard was also important since that protects Pamm whenever she misses her kicks. I also added some tiny details off camera since they were not that big of a deal, really. I also tried to play a bit with the color of the shoes since I didn't realize that I don't have colors for it. My colors are simple, but it works. I do aim to improve this area of my skills. Without further ado, here's the complete model for this video. In my opinion, I think the model turned out to be okay. I still wanted something to be yellow, so I just made it the background, which I think worked out actually. I think she looks too pretty, but I don't know. How do I lessen that factor? The pose do work well on her since she is playful whenever she gets into a fight. I am a bit proud of this model since this is my first original character. Also, I would like to give a heads up that I would be opening commissions soon. I will once again post in the community tabs when I would be opening. I also want to thank you guys for continuing to watch and support my channel. I feel guilty about posting lesser videos. I do have a good reason for it since I am still studying, but I am glad that the channel is still doing great. And for that, I thank you all. That's all for now, and see you in the next video.